Hello everyone. Welcome to English class once again. So, as you know, we had shared the syllabus in the last lecture. I had shared the syllabus in the last class, and then we had started with our first poem, that is Stopping by Woods on a Snowy Evening by Robert Frost. And as you know, we had read the poem and I think we had a brief discussion on the poet and the poem. So let us begin from where we had left in the last class. Once again, I would recite the poem. Whose woods these are, I think I know. His house is in the village though. He will not see me stopping here to watch his woods fill up with snow. My little horse must think it queer to stop without a farmhouse near, between the woods and frozen lake, the darkest evening of the year. He gives his harness bells a shake to ask if there is some mistake. The only other sounds the sweep of easy wind and downy flake. The woods are lovely, dark and deep, but I have promises to keep and miles to go before I sleep and miles to go before I sleep. Okay, so as you read the poem, I think I should keep the poem before you. As you read the poem, you understand that the speaker of the poem is a rider who is passing by the woods. By woods we understand forest, मतलब एक व्यक्ति जो है घोड़े पे बैठ के जा रहा है और जंगल के पास से गुजर रहा है. Because the poem starts at the very point whose woods these are, I think I know. तो मतलब वो राइडर जो है, जो हॉर्स राइडर जो है, वो जो वहां से पास हो रहा है और जंगल को देख के, वुड्स को देख के बोलता है, whose woods these are, I think I know. His house is in the village too. His माने the owner of the those woods. जो इस जंगल का मालिक है, his house is in the village too. He will not see me stopping here to watch his woods fill up with snow. So it seems that the woods look lovely. They look very charming. And that is why the horse rider has stopped there and he is just seeing them. And he loves the sight, as he says, that woods are filling up with snow. So it is looking so beautiful that I have stopped here and I don't want to leave this place. And I know that the owner of these woods, he lives in the village and I know where he lives. And he does not see me stopping here and watching this, his woods fill up with snow. So he has stopped there. And then my little horse must think it queer. We have moved to the second stanza. So mera jo ghoda hai, he must find it a little queer. Queer means strange. Usko thoda ajeeb lag raha hoga that I have stopped here without a farmhouse near. So I am already going to some, there is a destination. I am going to some place and there is no farmhouse near. So I don't think, the horse doesn't think that there is any reason to stop here. And that is why he must be finding it a little queer or strange to stop here without a farmhouse near. Between the woods and frozen lake, the darkest evening of the year. Between the woods and frozen lake, again, you can be asked a short question, describe the sight that the poet saw, the rider saw in stopping by woods on a snowy evening. Matlab, wo sight, wo drashya jo narrator ne dekha jungle mein, उसका डिस्क्रिप्शन कीजिए. तो इट्स द ब्यूटिफुल साइट वेयर द स्नो इज फॉलिंग, द वुड्स आर बीइंग फिल्ड अप विथ स्नो एंड देर इज ऑल्सो फ्रोजन लेक. So the horse finds it a little strange that the that his owner, that is to say this rider, has stopped here without a farmhouse near. So there is no reason to stop. If there is a farmhouse, that means he wants to rest. Par yahan pe to kahin pe dur tak koi farmhouse bhi nahi hai between the woods and frozen lake. And then it is the darkest evening of the year. Ye to matlab the darkest evening of the year matlab यहाँ पे तो बहुत ही अंधेरा हो चुका है, शाम हो चुकी है. एंड इट इज नॉट सेफ टू स्टैंड हियर, टू स्टॉप हियर. एंड स्टिल आई हैव स्टॉप्ड एंड आई एम जस्ट गेजिंग एट दोज रूट्स. एंड दैट इज व्हाई द हॉर्स मस्ट बी फाइंडिंग इट अ लिटिल स्ट्रेंज. एंड दैट इज व्हाई इन द थर्ड स्टैंजा द हॉर्स गिव्स हिज हार्नेस बेल्ट्स अ शेक. द हॉर्स गिव्स हिज हार्नेस बेल्ट्स अ शेक, माने जो घोड़ा है वो अपना जो हार्नेस बेल्ट उसके गले में जो घंटी है उसे थोड़ा सा शेक करता है टू मेक साउंड टू आस्क इफ देयर इज सम मिस्टेक. दैट मींस इफ द राइडर हैज मेड सम मिस्टेक टू स्टॉप हियर द हॉर्स एज इफ आस्क द ओनर द राइडर टू आस्क इफ देयर इज सम मिस्टेक टू स्टॉप हियर. There is, this is the only sound apart from the sounds, the sweep of easy wind and downy flake. Easy wind, मतलब वहाँ पे जो हवा चल रही है, the easy wind and downy flake, माने वहाँ पे downy flake माने the soft snow that is falling over there, the feathery snow that is falling over there. So the feathery snow that falls in the woods that makes very soft noise. And the easy wind that also makes very soft noise. So that apart from that soft noise, this is the only noise that he could hear at that time. So you can imagine how peaceful the sight must be, the place must be. Okay. So the horse gives his harness belts a shake to ask the owner if there is a mistake in standing there. So this is the background, this is the setting of the poem, that the rider is passing by the woods, he looks at the woods filling up with snow, he finds the sight very charming, beautiful, and he doesn't want to leave from there. The horse reminds him of the fact that there is no reason to stand there, because it is very dark, the evening is very dark, it has got very late and they should leave from there. Then in the last stanza, so until now, the rider had stopped and he didn't want to leave. But in the last stanza, as if he realizes that he cannot stand here anymore, he cannot stop here anymore. So let us read the last stanza. The woods are lovely, dark and deep, but I have promises to keep. The woods are lovely, dark and deep. But I have promises to keep and miles to go before I sleep and miles to go before I sleep. So this means the sight of the forest is very beautiful. The woods are lovely, dark and deep. मतलब ये जो दृश्य है वो बहुत ही सुंदर है, बहुत ही tempting है, लुभावने वाला है. लेकिन I have promises to keep. And I have miles to go before I sleep, before I take rest. By sleep we mean to take rest. मतलब यहाँ पे sleep का अर्थ करना है कि रुकने से पहले, आराम करने से पहले, I have miles to go. So the woods are lovely, dark and deep, but I have promises to keep. And miles to go before I sleep, and miles to go before I sleep means. The sight is very beautiful, it is mesmerizing, I don't want to leave from here, but I have realized the fact that I have promises to keep and I can't stop here. I can't stop here because I have so many miles to go before I sleep, before I take rest. Okay, so this is the literal meaning of the poem. Ye kavita ka shabdik arth hua. कि एक हॉर्स राइडर जो है वो एक सुंदर दृश्य देखता है कि कैसे बर्फ गिर रही है जंगल में, और वो वहाँ पे रुक जाता है टू सी द साइट, टू एंजॉय द ब्यूटी ऑफ द नेचर. एंड देन ही रियलाइजेज ऑल ऑफ अ सडन, एज इफ ही इज रिमाइंडेड बाय द हॉर्स ऑफ द फैक्ट दैट ही कांट स्टॉप हियर एनी मोर, बिकॉज यू नो द साइट माइट बी वेरी चार्मिंग बट he can't stop here because he has promises to keep. He has so many miles to go. He has such a long distance to go before he can take rest. So this is the literal meaning of the poem. Let me tell you, the meaning that is literal is very simple, very easy, and anyone who reads the poem very firstly can understand the meaning. मतलब कोई भी कविता को पढ़े तो ये इतना सिंपल है, इतनी सिंपल लैंग्वेज में लिखी गई है कि कोई भी समझ जाए कि ये इसका अर्थ क्या है. नाउ हैविंग अंडरस्टूड द लिटरल मीनिंग, लेट अस नाउ ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द अदर मीनिंग एंड व्हाट कैन बी द अदर मीनिंग ऑफ द पोएम. Now, by the way, how the poem was written? About that, it is believed. कविता कैसे लिखी गई, मतलब किस सिचुएशन में लिखी गई, उसके बारे में ऐसा कहा जाता है that the poem was written in 1922. Written by Robert Frost. So there is an incident that is actually connected with this poem, and this incident is that that is the incident in Robert Frost's life. The thing is that he was facing very degrading financial condition. And it is believed that this degrading financial condition was the key inspiration behind developing this thoughtful piece. माने इस कविता, इस विचार प्रेरक कविता को लिखने के पीछे का कारण जो है वो कवि की financial position, मतलब उनकी आर्थिक परिस्थिति जो है वो इतनी अच्छी नहीं थी, उसके कारण ये कविता लिखी गई थी. On a winter morning, on a winter morning, once, when the poet had gone to the local market to sell eggs, since he needed money to buy Christmas gifts for his children. So he had actually gone to the market to buy Christmas gifts for his children, to sell eggs. However, he was heartbroken because no egg was sold, as the trip was completely failure because there was no egg sold on that day. मतलब अपने बच्चों के लिए क्रिसमस गिफ्ट खरीदने के लिए वो मार्केट गए थे, और मार्केट में एक्चुअली वो एग अंडे जो है बेचने के लिए गए थे, लेकिन शाम हो गई, एक भी एग बिका नहीं. तो अनेबल टू कंटेन हिज ग्रीफ, फ्रॉस्ट स्टॉप्ड इन द मिडस्ट ऑफ हिज जर्नी टू वेंट आउट हिज इमोशंस व्हाइल हिज हॉर्स, हिज सोल कंपेनियन, शूक इट्स हार्नेस बेल आफ्टर वेटिंग फॉर लॉन्ग टू रिमाइंड हिज गोल. मतलब जब वहां से वापस आ रहे थे तो एक जगह पे वो रुक गए जर्नी में, वहां पे ही वो जस्ट यू नो जैसे वो इमोशनल हो गए उस समय पे और खड़े रह गए थे वहां पे, और तभी उनका हॉर्स जो है उसने उनको बाय शेकिंग हिज हार्नेस बेल द हॉर्स रिमाइंडेड हिम ऑफ द फैक्ट दैट ही कांट स्टॉप हियर एनी मोर, ही हैज टू गो, एज इफ द यू नो हॉर्स रिमाइंडेड हिम ऑफ हिज गोल. So this incident occurred way back in 1905, it is believed, and it is believed that this incident immensely impacted his mind. मतलब इस incident के कारण ये कविता जो है कवि को इस कविता को प्रेरित किया था इस इंसिडेंट ने. मतलब दिस इज कंसिडर्ड टू बी रॉबर्ट फ्रॉस्ट मास्टरपीस. ये कविता को फ्रॉस्ट का मास्टरपीस कहा जाता है. मतलब रॉबर्ट फ्रॉस्ट की अगर कहीं पे भी बात की जाए तो सबसे पहले इस कविता का जो है जिक्र किया जाता है. इतनी फेमस ये पोएम बन चुकी थी. एक इंसिडेंट इसके साथ ऐसे कनेक्ट किया गया है कि एक बार अपने बच्चों के लिए गिफ्ट खरीदने के लिए वो गए, लेकिन पैसे नहीं थे तो एग जो है बेचने के लिए गए थे, लेकिन बिका एग भी नहीं. तो ही वॉज सो इमोशनल एंड ही हैड स्टॉप्ड समवेयर. और तभी यू नो ही कुड नॉट स्टॉप एनी मोर बिकॉज ही हैड टू गो होम. द हॉर्स रिमाइंडेड हिम ऑफ हिज गोल एंड ही लेफ्ट द प्लेस देन. सो ये इंसिडेंट से ये कविता जो है प्रेरित है ऐसा कहा जाता है. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द इंसिडेंट्स इन हिज ओन लाइफ. Now, as we have seen the entire poem, it is a didactic poem and it offers a beautiful sight, which is, you know, the poet is successful in creating that visual and auditory images before our eyes. You know, this is a bright, beautiful kind of scene has been created before us, and at the same time, rural images have been created before our eyes, and the simple description can be that the horse rider stops by the woods, he sees the beautiful sight, and then he leaves the place, having been reminded of the fact that he has many more promises to keep before stopping there. This is the literal meaning. However, Frost is also very famous for the deep symbolism in his poem. Apparently, this seems to be the simple approach of the poet, that the rider is enchanted by the beauty and of the snow-covered deep woods on a dark, desolate night, with the horse being his sole companion. But then, let us read the poem once again, thinking that woods here stand for the beauty of nature or any other temptation in our life. मतलब जीवन में कोई भी temptation हो, कोई भी लालच हो, कोई भी desire हो, कोई भी इच्छा हो, उसके लिए the woods stand for that desire. और उस डिजायर को पूरी हम करना चाहते हैं, एक इच्छा को हम पूरी करना चाहते हैं, लेकिन हमेशा नहीं कर पाते हैं क्योंकि प्रोमिसेस टू कीप. आई हैव प्रोमिसेस टू कीप, क्योंकि कुछ फर्ज होते हैं, कुछ ड्यूटीज होती है, कुछ ऑब्लिगेशंस होते हैं. अगर वुड्स को डिजायर के का सिंबल समझ के पूरी कविता को फिर से पढ़ा जाए तो क्या अर्थ होता है. We can say that the poet actually here is sharing his own experience, but this can be the experience of all of us, that you know, while enjoying you know, the pleasures of life, the woods here stand for those pleasures of life. You know, while enjoying the pleasures of life, we might realize of the fact that this is not the life, this is not the only life. Because we can't always enjoy, we have promises to keep. Okay, so woods here stand for the temptations, for the desires, for the pleasures of life. Okay, that is one meaning. You can read the poem once again, keeping this thing in mind. The other meaning, you can say the second meaning is, the woods here stand for death, माने मृत्यु. कई लोगों ने, कई क्रिटिक्स ने इस कविता को सुसाइडल इंस्टिंक्ट के साथ कनेक्ट किया है. मतलब व्यक्ति जब कभी अपने जीवन में बहुत थक जाता है, हार जाता है, कभी कभी लाइफ की चैलेंजेस इतनी ज्यादा बढ़ जाती है, you know, the situations become so much challenging that he feels like dying. And in those situations, you know, death as if seems to him as if the only resting place. So now, you know, considering woods as the symbol of death, read the poem once again and you would realize that, you know, this person has become tired of the, you know, desires to live. He has become tired of the situations of life that are so challenging that he now finds death as the only place that can give him peace. So he wants to, as if, you know, end these challenging situations. And then my little horse must think it queer to stop without a farmhouse near. That means the little horse actually, you know, actually stands for those, you know, reminding people and those situations that actually remind us of, you know, the promises that we have to keep before ending the journey. So end of the journey means death. Okay, so this poem is often, you know, connected with this death instinct. And, you know, there are many, in fact, other things that also prove that the poet is actually talking about death. The darkest evening of the year. Matlab, ye dark, ek darkness jo hai, that is also the symbol of death. Then there is the reference to snow, which is also a symbol of death, because in the Western countries, you know, this snow is actually concerned, it is connected with death only. So in that way also, it becomes a poem where, you know, the poet is talking about death. So the death as a resting place might be very lovely place, might be very, you know, tempting place, but I have promises to keep. And I have miles to go before I can take rest. मतलब मुझे बहुत सारी duties, बहुत सारी promises हैं मेरी, बहुत सारे obligations हैं मेरे before I take rest, before I die. That is what the poet means. At the same time, the poet actually is, as I already told you, the poet actually is talking about the conflicting situation in the life of all of us. I would tell you that in each and every stage of our life, whether it's childhood or young age, you know, or it's an old age, you know, at all the points, all the moments in our life, you know, wherever we have to take decision, there is always a conflict. As William Shakespeare in his great drama Hamlet has said, to do or not to do, that is a question. To do or not to do, that is a question. Means, ye kare ya na kare, ye ek question hai, ye ek sawal hai. Matlab, kai sari situations jo hai, usme options jo hai, wo sare jo hai, hume kabhi confuse kar dete hain. Jaise ye vyakti yahan pe khada hai, aur use yahin pe ruk jana hai. Kyunki ye drashya bahut sundar hai. Lekin hamesha to nahi ruk sakta. Because I have promises to keep. Right? To kai baar, जो प्लेजर्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड ऑफ लाइफ है वो बहुत ही टेम्पटिंग है, लेकिन हम वही तो नहीं कर सकते हैं, क्योंकि हमारे भी तो कुछ फर्ज है, कुछ प्रोमिसज है, कुछ ड्यूटीज है, कुछ ऑब्लिगेशन है, एंड वी कॉन्ट फॉरगेट दैट. सो दैट एवर अकरिंग कॉन्फ्लिक्ट इन अवर लाइफ, दैट दोज मोमेंट्स इन अवर लाइफ, यू नो, दैट ऑलवेज कम इन, विच एक्चुअली यू नो स्टैंड फॉर द पैराडॉक्स. जीवन में एक विरोधाभास सा हो जाता है, ये भी करना है, वो भी करना है, लेकिन हमेशा वो ही नहीं कर सकते जो अच्छा लगता है, बिकॉज वी हैव प्रॉमिसेस टू गिव. सो इन दैट वे, यू नो, वी आर ऑलवेज टेम्प्टेड टू डू द थिंग्स दैट गिव अस अ लॉट ऑफ प्लेजर, बट वी कांट डू दैट ऑलवेज बिकॉज वी हैव प्रॉमिसेस टू गिव, बिकॉज देर आर सो मेनी ड्यूटीज. So these are the other meanings of the poem. And in fact, I would tell you all to read it and find your own meaning again. कविता जो है, कोई भी लिटरेचर है, कोई भी साहित्य जो है, वो लिख जाया लिखा जाता है एक बार, लेकिन जितनी बार उसे पढ़ा जाता है उतनी बार उसके मीनिंग किए जा सकते हैं। तो मतलब हम हमेशा से ही, एवरी टाइम, दिस इज कॉल्ड रीडर रिस्पॉन्स थियरी, मतलब हर बार जब वाचक जो है, रीडर जो है, जितनी बार उसे पढ़ता है उतनी बार ही कैन फाइंड हिज ओन मीनिंग। तो यू ऑल्सो रीड इट एंड यू कैन हैव योर ओन मीनिंग। बट एनी वे, इफ वी टॉक अबाउट द पोएट्स, इफ वी टॉक अबाउट द जनरल थीम्स ऑफ द पोएम, बेसिकली द वुड्स हियर स्टैंड फॉर टेम्पटेशन, दे ऑल्सो स्टैंड फॉर डेथ, वुड्स ऑल्सो स्टैंड फॉर ब्यूटी ऑफ नेचर that always attract us. The situation in the poem stand for conflict and paradox in our life. As I have already told you to keep a notebook with yourself, I request you all to write the themes in the poem. Because when you write answer, if you are asked what is the theme of the poem, you can write these themes. Now the tone of the poem, by tone we mean the general character or attitude of a writing, matlab likhte waqt kavi ka jo ek general character, ek general attitude rehta hai, approach rehta hai, ya phir ek musical ya vocal sound jo kavita mein rehta hai uski baat kar rahe hain, to yahan pe tone jo hai seems to be sad, melancholic and calm, मतलब थोड़े से पेंसिव मूड में वो है, थोड़े से सैड है और एकदम शांत है, एकदम पीसफुल है। सो दैट इज द टोन ऑफ द पोएम। एज अ शॉर्ट क्वेश्चन यू कैन बी आस्क्ड व्हाट इज द टोन ऑफ द पोएम। सो यू कैन राइट द टोन ऑफ द पोएम इज सैड, मेलेंकोलिक एंड काम। नाउ द मूड, व्हाट इज द मूड? फर्स्टली द मूड इज द मेन इमोशन इन द पोएम, how the poet is feeling at the time of writing the poem and how the reader would feel while reading the poem. So this the mood is of tranquility. The mood is tranquil, unfearful and silent. Tranquil because he is completely alone at that point of time. There is no one else except that companion horse with himself. Then unfearful, he is not scared of anyone, though it is the darkest evening of the year. मतलब इतना अंधेरा है और बिल्कुल अकेले हैं, फिर भी ही इज अनफियरफुल, रादर ही इज नॉट फियरफुल बिकॉज ही इज एंजॉयिंग द प्लेजर ऑफ ब्यूटी ऑफ द नेचर। मतलब जंगल की सुंदरता को वो एंजॉय कर रहे हैं और इसीलिए वो फियरफुल नहीं है, ऐसा भी कहा जा सकता है। सो ही इज अनफियरफुल एंड साइलेंट, कंप्लीट कामनेस, कंप्लीट पीस, देयर इज द मूड इज वेरी पीसफुल। So what is the mood of the poem? The mood is tranquil, unfearful and silent. In fact, in the theme, let us go back to theme, you can also say that one of the themes of the poem is isolation. You know how isolation can also be the temptation in one's life. Matlab jeevan mein kabhi kabhi isolation, akela hona bhi kitna acha lagta hai, kitna attract karta hai hame. No, we don't want to be disturbed by anyone. We don't want to, tell anyone what we are feeling right now. So, वो isolation जो है, वो शायद woods symbolize कर रहे हैं यहाँ पे। Now, what is the atmosphere? As I told you, as a short question, you can be asked, what is the, how is the atmosphere of the poem? So firstly, you have to describe that it is a horse rider who is passing by the woods and he comes across a charming sight of the woods being filled up by snow. And he's so mesmerized by the scene that he doesn't want to leave from there. When all of a sudden he realizes that he can't stand here, stop here anymore, because he has obligations, he has promises to keep. So atmosphere here is beautiful, of the woods and the frozen lake. It's a beautiful, it is mysterious. Why mysterious? There is a mystery, because wherever there is darkness, wherever there is lack of light, there is mystery. And wherever there is mystery, the beauty is enhanced. So the atmosphere is mysterious. It is peaceful. There is no noise except the sweep of that easy wind and the downy flake. So it is peaceful and the atmosphere is also silent. There is no noise over there. So in every way, the atmosphere is beautiful. It is mysterious. It is peaceful and silent. In every way, it is attracting. It is attractive. Yeah, so that is atmosphere. Now, you can be asked figures of speech in this poem. So, as I was reading the poem, because I have already recited the poem many times. So, by the way, I'll discuss the other things in the next class. Thank you. See you in the next class.